In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Yamet, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Thursday, the 27th of October, 2022. 30th week in ordinary time, and participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Siwangile Mwale from Gaborone, Botswana, celebrating her birthday today, takes for us the first reading. Plani Lentu from Vupeto, Germany, who celebrated her birthday on the 24th of this month, takes for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Januarius Elijah Mutinda, a Carmelite missionary working in Barcelona, Spain. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. Take the whole armor of God, that you may be able, having done all, to stand. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 to 20. Finally, brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we are not contending against flesh and blood, but against the principalities, against the powers, against the world rulers of this present darkness, against the spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, take the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand, therefore, having fastened the belt of truth around your waist, and having put on the breastplate of righteousness, having shod your feet with the equipment of the gospel of peace, above all, taking the shield of faith, with which you can quench all the flaming darts of the evil one, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray at all times in the Spirit, with all prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert with all perseverance, making supplication for all the saints and also for me, that utterance may be given me in opening my mouth boldly to proclaim the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chain, that I may declare it boldly as I ought to speak. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm 144, verse 1, 2, 9 to 10. The response is taken from Psalm 144, verse 1a, and the response is, Blessed be the Lord my rock.
Blessed be the Lord my rock.
Blessed be the Lord my rock, who trains my hands for battle, who prepares my fingers for war.
Blessed be the Lord my rock.
He is my merciful love, my fortress. He is my stronghold, my savior, my shield in whom I take refuge. He brings peoples under my rule.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
To you, O God, will I sing a new song. I will play on the 10-stringed harp to you, who give kings their victory, who set David your servant free from the evil sword.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
A reading from the Old Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 13, verses 31 to 35. On that day some Pharisees came and said to Jesus, "Get away from here, for Herod wants to kill you." And he said to them, "Go and tell that fox, beyond thy cast out demons and perform cures today and tomorrow, and that day I finish my course. Nevertheless, I must go on my way today and tomorrow and the day following, for it cannot be that a prophet should perish away from Jerusalem. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, killing the prophets and stoning those who are sent to you, how often would I have gathered your children together as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, and you would not. Behold, your house is forsaken. And I tell you, you will not see me until you say, 'Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Tomorrow we are finishing the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians, and we are still drawing lessons. The final exhortation sums up everything. Because in this final exhortation, Paul explains how we are going to manage to live our family life, how we'll fight those forces that affect us. Listen, we are at war. And it's not a physical war. That's where we go wrong. Many of us go wrong because we think it is just what is facing me now that is the problem. We are forgetting that what we are dealing with are only effects. If there is confusion in your marriage, that confusion in your marriage or even your spouse having an affair somewhere is just an effect of a war that is supposed to be fought, an effect of a cause that is a spiritual cause. Oh, am I exaggerating? No, I am not exaggerating. Unless you have this eye of looking at things in this way, you will never win any battle. Because many of us come and complain, "This is what is happening to my spouse. And I see this is because of his drunkenness." And we don't understand that his drunkenness is just an effect. There is a cause. And the cause is deeper than what you are seeing. Paul makes the Ephesians understand that the war we are having is not physical. He says, "For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places." That is what we are fighting against. You know, the devil is very happy if we are unable to detect his operating system. He's very happy when we are ignorant about the way he does things. The devil is like the virus in our computer system. The devil comes quietly and you see your computer slowing down and you think the slowing down is because you have loaded your computer with many things. That's just an effect. That slowing down is just an effect. The cause is something else. There is a virus, there is a malware in your system. That is why that computer has slowed down and you start attributing it to something physical, or because you loaded your computer with a lot of things, that's why it is doing that. And you forget there may be a malware somewhere, there may be a virus somewhere that is slowing down everything. And if you don't detect that, your computer will crash. That is exactly the same thing in our workplaces, in our businesses. You see your family life slowing down. You see your businesses slowing down, and you attribute this to physical effects. Yes, physical effects may be affecting your own business, but they are not causes. I want you to understand this. They are not causes. Causes are much deeper than that. And if you don't learn to spiritualize something, then the evil one will indeed take advantage of you and will make you think this is a physical battle. And since you think it's a physical battle, you will try to use your strength to deal with it. You won't manage, you won't win it. And some of you have ended up in prison because you thought it was a physical battle and you ended up being in a fight with your spouse, and in the end you found yourself in trouble. You ended up fighting physically with that woman, having an affair with your spouse, and in the end you caused trouble and you found yourself in the arms of law. I'm telling you, you have to change the way you look at things. It is not a physical warfare. It is a spiritual one. And so we must now put on a combat. We must now dress like the way people were dressing at the time of Paul for war. It's not like the way our soldiers are wearing nowadays, because things are lighter now. Just a bulletproof vest. And then something is put outside, a coat is put outside where they can put the bullets, and that's it, they are prepared. But you know what? At the time of Paul, they had to put on something solid, even metallic, to prevent that sword from touching their body. And so Paul now explains how we are going to fight this war. We must have a proper military attire. And this is what we are going to put on to fight the schemes of the evil one. We are going to put on the armor of God. We are going to equip ourselves with things godly. Because when we do so, the devil will not have anywhere to penetrate. We have to fasten on the belt of truth. Truth must be in us. People must trust us with the way we conduct ourselves. People must say, yes, in this one, only truth comes out, not lies. Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. If he is the truth, I'm going to put on his truth. I will be sincere in my dealings. I will make sure that whatever I do is in line with God's will. I will do things right. Then I am going now to put on the breastplate of righteousness. Breastplate is like the bulletproof. What will protect your chest? What will protect the essential organs of your system? He says, is righteousness. Being righteous means being in a position to do things right. That is righteousness. That you are always doing things right. And doing things right is living according to your nature. You are a man, be a man. You are a woman, be a woman. You are a man, marry a woman. You are a woman, marry a man. That is righteousness. And we want to say it's not easy to put on that breastplate of righteousness, especially living in a society that is dictated by wealth. And people are trying to do everything to gain that wealth. There is compromise. We are not protecting ourselves properly. We want that righteousness. That righteousness is seen in the way I remain true to the call God has given me. I am meant to be a priest and I remain a priest. I'm meant to be a sister and I remain a sister. I am meant to be a married man. I remain a married man. I'm meant to be a married woman. I remain a married woman. And I want to show to others that I am comfortable. I am content with the call God has given me, with the vocation God has entrusted to me. I am very comfortable with that. And the shoes. What are we supposed to put on as shoes? They must be very strong on my feet. These shoes are my readiness. Being ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. That wherever I go, I tell people about the peace that Christ wants to bring in humanity. The peace that Christ wants to bring among us. I'm not causing discord, but I am bringing peace wherever I am. That is my shoe. How beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. Romans chapter 10, verse 13 to 15 will tell you the role you have in your shoes. You are not supposed to be telling others of how terrible somebody is. You are bringing discord. You are not bringing unity and peace, because that's what you are supposed to put on as your shoes. In all circumstances, take up the shield of faith. Holding that shield, it is faith, my own faith. My faith is something that is going to protect me from the attacks of an enemy. My faith is what is going to protect my family. Nothing else. Not the concoction you take from a witch doctor to strengthen your marriage. That doesn't work. It will backfire. It will work against you. Your faith is your shield, and let that faith guard you and guide you. And it says the helmet of salvation is what you should put on, and the sword of the Spirit. The Holy Spirit should be your sword. You are going to attack others by the word, because that Holy Spirit, he says, it is the word of God. The word of God is a sword. The word of God is what you are going to use to attack the evil one. Jesus himself in his temptations used the word of God. It is written, he would say, telling the devil, get away from me. I rely on the word of God, and I am not going to listen to you. I will listen to what the word of God is telling me. And with that, I am equipped. I am ready to face the attacks of the enemy. The gospel passage of today shows us how Jesus was brought to face the evil demon in Herod, where people thought Jesus was going to be afraid of Herod. He says, go and tell that fox. Tell that fox. He's just a fox. How are foxes like? They are shrewd. They are quick to act. And no one will know exactly what they are up to. That's a politician's attitude. And he says, I'm not afraid of that fox. I must fulfill what I was sent to do. Do not be afraid of any power. Do not be afraid of any force. Because at the end of the day, they have no power over your life. It is God who brought you here, and you are supposed to spread that righteousness all over the world. Let people know that you have only your God to fear when you are doing the right thing, when you are the soldier of Christ, putting on the combat, putting on that military attire. You will have no one to fear, because you are safeguarded, and God will fight your battles. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Thursday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I this is the air.